you want to tell these guys? What's the first thing you want to say? Go what?
On TV.
The TV's right there.
Yeah.
Go Jags. You're clamming up?
Yeah.
Yeah? Here we go. This is Henry Milton Stiegelmeier, our youngest. Happy to get the win. I know that we have real high expectations. The fans have real high expectations. My wife has real high expectations. I'm happy we got the win. Can we play better? Can we coach better? Yeah, that's the goal every week. And I'm happy those expectations are there. I thought Western did a good job in some areas. They're building that program, and I know their coaches, a number of their coaches, and hat off to them for what they did. And then just want to thank the fans. What a great turnout for the game. Beautiful day, and they make a difference. And so keep coming. Any questions?
John, I think 270 rushing yards, time of possession was like 42-18 or something. Was that the plan, to really try to milk the clock and run the ball and, I don't know, shorten the game, or did it just kind of play out that way?
I think it played out that way. I think the passes we tried early were defended pretty well. We dropped a long one. We got sacked a couple times when we got rushed, a couple long ones. So, again, I think give the Leathernecks some credit and give our fat guys some credit. And Isaiah Davis had a good day. So it was fun to see him doing what he does so well.
He was in a really good mood when he was in here.
Was he?
You know, 200 yards, his first two touchdowns of the year. And, you know, he had been pretty I was impressed by how patient he's been the first few weeks, you know, not getting upset about not breaking any of those long runs. He kept saying we're just, you know, one inch away or whatever on all these different plays. I mean, just how nice was it to see that sort of patience on his part rewarded?
Well, it's nice for a number of reasons. You know, you want that to happen for a player, but he's such a great team player. He didn't want to break us down. You know, his humility overrode, you know, going in the middle, and I made him break us down. We know he can do. He knows what he can do. He finally got to do it today. So,
Mark had a great game last week. It looked like he was a little off today. What did you think?
I think he was a little off. I think, and I, like I said in the radio, everybody has an off day. You know, you get to check your script and maybe redo it, but it's not always perfect the first time through. You know, he's very hard on himself. And like I said pregame, he's a mechanical engineer. I mean, he doesn't have a free second. He comes from class. We give him this lengthy game plan. But he's a really good player, and I'm glad he's our quarterback.
What do you think of your defense?
I thought they played the run really well. I thought there were a couple passes that they went back. And then I think we need to tackle better. And if Coach Rogers was in here, that would have been the first thing he said. So, what did you think of the defense?
Yeah.
Yeah? Good. Agreed.
Jason Freeman got his second start today. He's been playing really well. You know, what have you thought of his first two starts?
I think he's a really good player. I think he's got all the things you need to play the position he does. And I think it's amazing how much defense we play and how short a time he's been with us and how well he's doing. So I'm really excited. And that's a guy that will get better every week because just becoming familiar with all the stuff we do.
How's Zach Hines doing?
I don't know that yet. I didn't get the report. He was fine in the first half, and then when he came in for halftime, he couldn't come out. So ideally, he'll be fine.
Get an explanation on the non-targeting on that play?
Is this possible to say no comment?
They just said no, it's not.
Yeah, no, they don't. I don't get that. Yeah. You know, I'll have to go to, and we're not going to do that. But we'd send it in. We could send it in and say, why isn't this targeting, or is it, and so on. No, we get an answer. Bill Carrillo, the Big Ten officials, they do a good job. So we're almost done. Hang in there, okay?
Well, you have two rivalry games in a row coming up now, and you know we make a bigger deal out of that than you guys maybe, but. When you did see the schedule that you had those two games back-to-back, did you care at all? Did you think, geez, that's a lot to have those two in a row, or do you not even think about it?
It's kind of like when you play, when you coach. You something goes through your mind. Does it seem tougher? Yes. Then you don't dwell on it. You play in the present. And so we're going to focus on the University of South Dakota. We're going to enjoy this victory, focus on the University of South Dakota, and then move on to whoever's next. So, but there's nothing you can do about it. And so, you know, control the things you can control.